All right, welcome back. Here's another wonderful thing that happens in Alaska. You'll see a lot of the ice thing that dangles, the ice flows, because of the snow melt. You'll see a lot of that like alongside the roads.
The ice falls.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that there's water flowing in off down the cliff, and normally in the summer you don't see it. Sometimes it's even under the rocks, but in the winter, of course, when water freezes, it expands, and you get more visible ice flows.
And to me, a lot of this is actually, for me, reminiscent of my time in New Mexico. Actually, a lot of the trees look like that. The same up there. Are we finding prints?
It was a piece of grass. I thought it was a moose hair. I'm sorry. I got excited.
We all get all sorts of excitement, especially during the summertime. Our summertime videos may not be as much because we are both busy. But we will do as much as we can and show off what our beautiful town and trails are. This is actually pretty cool.
Oh my gosh, hun. There's a big icicle fall around the corner.
Oh, you can just barely see it through the trees right here. I'm gonna try and stand far back but to give, this is what a lot of people come here for.
Especially now that it's all warm and melty like this, it would be a really, really bad idea to get up in there. I just really want to. I'm not going to, though.
We like to try and keep things safe.
Yep.
But you can see like there's like an ice wall back there,
Look how it's so far forward because the cliff is projecting. Oh, man.
And like during around this time is when you get a lot of the ice hikers or I don't know, ice climbers.
People who climb the ice falls?
Yeah.
Not on a day like this, though, and definitely not this ice fall.
Not this one, but and they get bigger too.
The ones out in Mud Bay are spectacular.
And we'll show you what Mud Bay is like. Mud Bay is down Pyramid Island where I was showing you guys earlier, which from here that way is Mud Bay.
Well, is referred to as Mud Bay.
Yeah, well, that's also where Pyramid Island is. We could actually almost walk to it from here.
Yeah. One of Dad's pet peeves is them calling everything on the Chilkat River Mud Bay.
Your dad, right?
My dad, yeah.
On the, on, you know, on
Just for clarity's sake.
just for clarity. I don't think we'll see any of him on, we'll ask, but we probably won't see any of him. My dad is famous beyond famous, so I'm kind of a bit of a I'm a bit it's I don't like to say celebrity, but I'm well known in this town, and my dad is well known throughout Southeast.
Between your dad and where you currently work, everybody in town knows Stephen. Can you see the kind of the blue-green stain behind this tree?
It the one that looks like it's been spray painted. Is that like a algae or something? Be careful.
This one is actually, and you should recognize this color. This is evidence of copper. There's trace amounts of copper in this hill, and it's been flushed out and oxidized by the water, and it makes this green stain. So the color of the Statue of Liberty. That's the same process going on here. Because the Statue of Liberty
Be careful.
oxidized. Yep, I know. I'm getting well attached to this tree here.
And the reason why this is important is that in native cultures, or in my native culture, in the Tlingit culture, we used the oxidation of copper to make our paints. theoretically made, the base was salmon eggs, theoretically speaking. And the reason why I say theoretically is, you know, it's, you gotta imagine putting raw salmon eggs in your mouth, chew them up, and just spit out the liquid, and you're filtering the shells with your teeth. That's why, for me, I say theoretically. I think there is a...
I ate raw salmon eggs when I was a kid. It wasn't bad. You want them really, really fresh, or they're kind of fishy.
Yeah. I think we are kind of getting off what looks like... Oh, no, that's the trail.
Yep.
Sorry.
Apologies again for being a feral girlfriend.
Feral, of course, to the ones who don't know, is wild. My girlfriend likes to go, you know, off camera, we were climbing trees and stuff, so. Well, not we, just her. But. In the ice, like this, you know, you kind of, what I call, walk like a penguin. What are we looking at?
It's just so pretty. Well, I mean, there's rocks and trees and a big fallen pine.
And this happens a lot too, is how it was explained to me is that the wind blows and the trees twisting uproots the whole tree itself. It loosens up the ground after it gets so big.
Well, it's very hard to get good root purchase as a tree here, because we're pretty much, I mean, you can see, we're right on top of the bedrock here. We just don't have that deep soil for a tree to root itself in. So we get a lot of trees that fall down in windstorms or due to freeze thaw action.
It's practically under its own weight.
Yeah. It's possible that this one came down when the cliff did, but it looks like the cliff has been down for a lot longer based on how rounded the rocks are and how much moss and everything has grown up on top of them.
Yeah, but to give you an idea of the view that we get, that's the snow-capped mountains in the background is actually in front of Hangs, to give you an idea on how far away. So like in between this huge hill, or what I call a hill, here on the left, and then that little hump, right in between there is actually Hangs. I'm saying right in there.
Right here.
You think it's over?
Yeah, because that's multiple miles. We did not travel more than 1 mile out of town before we drove. So we should...
But remember, on the backside too.
That's the hill past my bed.
From what I've seen on like aerial maps and stuff, I believe that's where it's at. I've been wrong before. That's why I bring her.
I've also been wrong.
Yeah, once again, Jones Point is a trailhead all the way at the end of where the Eagle Nest Hotel is. This would would you say that this sign would be used for beware of bear in the area kind of sign? Considering that it's... And that's why we don't like, you know, and it happens here in this town too, is vandals. You know, they'll think that it's...
Based on how yellowed and fragile this is, I think this probably just broke down on its own.
Could be, but, you know, it's not a new thing about having vandals. We get them as well, but, man, I'm sorry, guys. I got to come out this way again and check out the view. Once again, we got more broken ice. I think... I can't get enough of it. But I'm gonna come out this way and show you the view from here. Torturous. This is torturous. That's Pyramid Island off in the distance. I forgot what mountain range that is in front of us. Yeah.
These are the Chilkats.
The Chilkat Mountain Range?
Yep. Chilkat Mountain Range, Chilkat River. Yep. It's all on the west side of town. The sun sets behind the Chilkats.
So like, you know, you get that bright thing and it looks amazing on camera. I just can't get enough of it. I'm sorry. I want to continue on with the trail, but I'm stuck admiring the view. My girlfriend's a great view too, but you know, that's beside the point. Is that like an area that you like? Is that?
I find it fascinating. I don't know all that much about it. I know people who know a lot more about it than I do. But I could give you a general, basic idea of what we're looking at here.
You know, it's just your. For me, I just look at it and see rock, boulder, you know, but. And really, really nice view. I believe. Above my finger there is Sullivan?
That could be.
It's either Sullivan or Glacier Point. Right?
Right.
It's hard telling because, you know, we, one, no map, and two, it's just pretty.
It's really bright out.
Yeah. And we got some sand in the area. Where to now? Shall we just continue on?
I'm curious if that sign was a private property sign.
Do we see houses in the near? I mean, there's a house up that way.
Way down there, but...
Way down there, but... And also, you know, it's as much as a worry as we are, another thing that we should kind of try to point out is that it's not... like Texas, so to speak. They will get grumpy, yes, but they're not gonna get like bring out the rifles and try and shoot at you kind of grumpy. I've never heard of those kind of incidents ever. It was more of a all right.
Cool. What a gorgeous day. I'm so glad we did this.
Yeah, me too. This means that we do. So I think we're just going to make it more of a leisure kind of a rest of this video. I kind of don't want to push it, so I kind of want to feel safe to turn around. So it looks, to give it a better idea, it looks more like shattered glass.
It's rotting in the way ice rots, and it's making these, sorry to be breaking up the nice ice, but there will be more. It
melts into these little segments. And when we were walking up, I heard some fall. And so I knew there was some of this over here.
So it splinters then?
Yeah, the ice is splintering. There's a technical name for this. I'll research it and get back to you.
I don't want to do this too much, but just to give you a...
It might be called candle ice, but I'm not sure.
Huh. Okay, let's see. Let's go back up, I guess.
Probably safe.
We don't want to go and impose on someone else's property, so we're kind of working our way back.
We'd rather be overcautious than undercautious, especially
when
we're
so going back may not be as slow as going out, and I'll try and get some more camera views as well. We stopped?
I was walking behind you, so I didn't know
what to do. I'm glad I pulled my big boots on today.
Yeah, not
really hard. Yeah. But I just, you know, this view. I'm continue walking, so it's a little bit shaky. It's just the view. We'll get up to there. I'm just still, you know, on another point of Hang's history. Did you hear that?
Yeah. Could have been ice shifting.
That sounded like a spurt from a whale.
Uh-huh. Oh, it's the wind coming through this spruce tree.
No, that was not what I heard. I know what that sounds like. It sounds like a...
I know.
And it was instantaneous. It wasn't like a when wind goes through a tree. Anyways.
But would we have heard it from here? Wind traveling in towards that direction?
Good point. So we'll go check out this rock that my girlfriend is. Point it out. I'm gonna go this way. Just because it looks kinda. Yeah. Oh, that's why we didn't see it, because it was on the other. You know, here's the. I'm one of those people who kind of want to try and get up there, but it's another thing that you'll see in Alaska, because in Hangs was an old logging town, so you'll see a bunch of rusty stuff laying around. This one's actually pretty far away, and it's frayed. You know, it actually goes underneath. I bet you that's why they snapped it.
Do you think they were trying to move this rock?
No, I think they were trying to tie up to it. Because remember, this area did not look like this.
Yep.
About, you know, give or so, beginning of the 19th century. This was all ocean. The glacier that came from that way, which carved this whole area. If you look actually how it's all rounded, that's actually how tall supposedly the glacier was. And this area back in the early 1900s was all, and boats used to come up this far.
So
this is actually pretty,
150 years ago the airport was a deep water harbor.
This is actually near the spot. Well, not, you know, it's still about 4 miles up the road, probably, but this is near the spot where the canoes were, of a picture that's in our local clinic.
Let's see if we can get a copy of that picture and then see if we can find the exact spot where it was taken.
That'd be fun. We like to have fun.
Yep.
But, you know, it was like you look here and, you know, I know that wire wasn't used in the early 1900s, but, you know, it's...
Jones Point was a logging mill at Jones Point in the 50s and 60s, the 1950s and 60s.
A little bit of foreshadowing, just so then the viewers know now. I'll explain more in the videos, but my girlfriend used to work at our local museum, so she knows a lot more of the history here than I do, so to speak. Yes. Now she's being modest.
And accurate.
This is fun. We'll have to do this a lot more.
Yeah. We'll probably get back.
Just wait until we start get a real hand camera. And get some really good videos. You know, like... Where are we going? I want to go and, you know, admire the... Sorry. I got distracted by the views again. Once again, you know, this... I think we were actually just here recently. Because... It looks like a table.
Yep.
And to give you an idea, you know, my hand width is roughly about 8 inches wide. Roughly.
There's at least a foot of ice there.
And if you take the, you know, and if I go like this, so from here to here is roughly about 8 to 10 inches. And that's clearly at least nearly almost a foot.
Mm-hmm.
It's about 10 inches right there. I think this, from here to here for me, is about, 8 inches, I think.
I've got tiny
guesstimation.
Hands.
Guesstimation.
Yeah.
But just to give you a size reference on how thick this actually is, and it just looks cool.
Yep. And it's sitting on these rocks.
And I think we have your
completely above. Yeah, it's starting to do the candle ice thing.
The ice rot that you were talking about earlier. This is what it.
Yep.
And it's not a bad thing.
No, it's natural. This is how we get our water in our soil.
That actually looks cool.
Doesn't it?
Alright. Talk about an image right there. I wish I was more like a professional photographer, because if you have the camera like right here looking this way, and I'll do it again a little bit more so the viewers can see, but if you take a picture of right where my hand is at, that actually looks real cool because the sun is right above where the ice is. Let me scoot over. I'm gonna get out of the way so then she can get the picture. That's why I turned up the brightness on mine.
Yeah, my brightness is
Alright, we got 5 minutes left on this video. But man. Alright, I'm gonna do something kind of not exactly the brightest thing to do. But I am going to attempt, because of how thick it is, it should be safe, right? And it's not like slippery, so I'm gonna try and. Hey! I'm just enjoying this way too much. Alright, let's get back onto the. See if we can find anything interesting that's on the trail that we may have missed. Like a video comparison too sometime later on.
It's in there.
Let's go back this way. So we're headed south to go down around these trees because the full I guess you'd call it the foliage, I guess.
Uh-huh.
It's just too thick to go through. And it gets thick. Thick and quick. Alright. Small tree.
Our lesson earlier, can I get you to name that tree?
Ashwood? No.
That's what you called it earlier. What are these?
Something you don't want to use to wipe with?
Very true. It's a pine. See, these are pine needles. Is this a coastal pine or a shore pine?
Shore pine. Okay.
Shore pine.
Not a porcupine, shore pine.
Okay. Now I want a picture of a porcupine in a shore pine.
It does happen. We do get porcupines here in Hangs.
Yep. They eat our gardens.
We'll elaborate more on that if we get permission to record where my girlfriend currently lives. I want to do this more, get permissions, and it's going to be weird in the beginning. Here, everyone in Hangs watching me carrying around a camera. This is different for us in a small town. In the big towns, you see everybody with the selfie sticks, cameras and such. We don't get that too much here. You don't get locals walking around with cameras and stuff recording everything like a tourist.
Although we do have a number of professional photographers that live here.
Here's what you were talking about again earlier, I do believe, right?
Yeah, the copper.
So that would mean
oxidation.
That somewhere in this rock is copper.
I believe so.
It's a mineral-rich area, for sure. And we're...
And very diverse, geologically speaking, too, but we'll get into that later.
Yeah, we gotta stop this video again. We'll see you here momentarily. Trying not to keep these videos too long, but not too big of a pause in between each one. So we'll see you here in a couple... About, I don't know, 20, 30 seconds probably. I'll let the video go until then, but it's great. I like this. This is fun.